Everyone. So in this video, we are going to learn mathematical typing in MS Word. Now we have this notion that mathematical typing is really difficult, but then I believe that there are two things which we can work on. The very first is we can practice a lot so that it becomes easier for us, and also we can write the equations really quick. The second one is a very smart trick, is to use the shortcuts. So if you remember some basic shortcuts, you can easily write these equations really fast, and those who write it from the scratch takes a little longer because they do not know some of the shortcuts which are really helpful when we write these equations. So I'll just move into the equation section. In this class, we are going to write these certain functions which I have taken, certain equations. I have taken four basic equations over here. So we are going to write these basic four equations from scratch. I'm not going to use any shortcuts in my first class so that you all are really accustomed with the writing of an equation, and then from our next class we are going to use shortcuts, and I will also make a list of entire shortcuts for you all so that you can refer it anytime you want. So the first is to go to the insert tab, and here we have a symbols group. So in the symbols group, there are two different things you can see. First feature is the equation, and second is the symbols. In the symbol, you can insert many symbols over here. These are the recently used symbols which we see. Once you click on the more symbols option, you get a window where you can select your symbols from these subsets. So suppose if I want symbols from Greek, basically Greek symbols, I can just click on this Greek and I get all these Greek symbols. You can also change the font. Generally, I don't prefer to change the font. I just keep it to maybe Arial or the Calibri, because these two are the basic ones which we use. And then you can just click on any one of these and click on the insert button. The moment you click on the insert button, this is added to your MS Word, to your sheet over here. Now, as you can see, the moment you add any equation, any symbol, it gets added to your recently used symbols. Now, these recently used symbols are really helpful. Why? Because these are the ones we generally use. So you see, you have alpha, beta, you have delta, so omega. So all of these are ones which we use generally for our mathematical typings. So it's preferable that what we do is we make a list of 6-7 important symbols, and we type it down so that it gets added to our recently used ones, and so that we don't have to navigate through the large list of symbols which we see over here. You can just use the recently used ones. Then we have some special characters, and these special characters are, some of these are basic ones. You have a lot of shortcuts for this. I'm not going to deal with a lot of shortcuts because then it becomes really difficult for us to remember all of these at once, and it's really overwhelming also. So I'll just click on the close button for the time being. We have this equation section over here. I'll click on the drop down. Now these are the built-in equations which we see over here. So these built-in equations are the ones which are generally used. And suppose you see a Pythagoras theorem. Now you want to insert a Pythagoras theorem equation, but then you want to change the numbers. Maybe you need to change this ABC to XYZ. You can do that. You can insert this and you can change the numbers. You can change, you can just simply change the ABC. You can add a minus sign as well. So all these can be done. These are the basic ones. In this class, I'm going to write these equations from scratch without using the built-in ones, right? So for using writing these from the scratch, we'll click on this insert new equation. The moment I click on the insert new equation, I get this over here. So I'll remove this first, and then we get a tab, type equation here. This is the tab in which we are going to write our equation. Now you can write this in bold if you're making notes, that there is a golden rule when we write any equation from scratch, is that to start from the outermost of any equation. So if you're going to write this equation, you start from the square root and then you move inside and you use the fraction. Now before going into the details, let me just show you all. We have in this new tab which is formed, once you click on this type equation here, you get a new tab. which is the design tab over here. In this, we see something as symbols. So these are the, again, basic symbols which we see. You can go to the basic math ones. So you have basic math symbols over here. Then you can go to the Greek letters. So you have all the Greek letters over here. You can also access different arrows, operators. We have different structures. Now these are very important when we write an equation from scratch. We have fractions. So we have different kinds of fractions. Also in each of these structures, you will see some common ones beneath. So these are the common ones. As you can see, pi by 2, dy by dx. So these are common ones which are generally used in our equations, which are already being added by the word, right? Then we have the superscript, subscript. Again, we have certain common ones. Then we have the radicals, the cube roots, square roots, and the common ones are also added over here. We have the integrals. So I'm not going into very detail of these because you can just see and analyze that this is a definite integral, this is an indefinite integral. Then we have the double integrals, we have the triple integrals. Also, we have large operators, like we use the summation and the product over here. Then we have all the three brackets. We have different trigonometric functions, inverse trigonometric functions. We have all the axioms, basically used when we are going to deal with annuities. And then we have the limit, log, ln, max, min, all of these. Also, we have certain common ones added. We have different operators over here, like plus, minus, is equal to, and all of these. Then we have the matrices. So these are the structures which are generally used. And in today's class, we are almost going to use all of these. Starting from the very first, let me just write it down. I'll start with writing L is equal to. So you can use your keyboard. L is equal to, and I will move from the outermost to the innermost. Now, outermost over here is the square root. So I'll use the radical square root, and then you need to click on this box which appears over here, the dotted box. So just click on this dotted box. The moment you click, it gets highlighted. And over here, we need something as V by H. So V by H again is a fraction. So I need to insert a fraction over here. So I'll insert a fraction in. You again get two boxes. So you need to click on the numerator, you write V, you click on the denominator, it gets highlighted, and you write an H. So this was the first symbol, or first equation. I think it just took me 30 seconds to write this. Once we use shortcuts, I think it becomes 15 seconds. So we are going to deal with the shortcuts in the next class. So this was the very first equation which we have written, the basic one. I'll click on the enter, move on to the next line, and then we are going to deal with the next one. So now, instead of going to the insert tab, going to the equation section, clicking on more insert equation, or just clicking on this particular pi, what I could have done is, instead of going through all of these, I could have used a shortcut, alt is equal to. So I'll type alt is equal to, and it adds a equation over here. Now alt is equal to is only shortcut which I have told you all in this video, and which is the only shortcut which we are going to use. Alt is equal to adds the equation over here, right? I'm just going to type in the equation. So the first the next equation says H is equal to. Now you need to analyze the equation as to what comes to the outermost and what comes in the innermost. As you can see, if you start by writing the brackets, then it becomes a little difficult because you need to add a superscript over here, which is 1 by 3. So this is the outermost part of this particular equation which we see. Now how to get this? We'll go to the script over here. In this script, we have something as subscript and superscript. I'll click on the superscript one because this is the superscript which has been added. Not going into the superscript first, I'll just type in the bracket portion. You can do the superscript first as well. It's exactly up to you. So I'll just push this a bit. And then over here, we have within the brackets. So I'll use the first bracket over here, which we say. Again, click on this dotted box. Again, we have a fraction. So insert a fraction. It might seem a little lengthy, but then once you get used to it, it becomes really easier and faster. Then we have a pi. Now pi is available in the symbol section. In the symbol section, in the Greek letters, you have pi over here. So I'll just click on the pi and you get it gets inserted over here. Now in the superscript again we have a fraction which is 1/3. So again I'll have to get a fraction. Numerator is 1, the denominator is 3. So I'm not using any, if you can notice, I'm not using any shortcuts. I think when we use shortcuts, all of these selections which we face an issue with, like if I want to select this 3, so it is really difficult for me to do this when I use a mouse. But when I use shortcuts, it becomes really easy. But then it's really important that you first learn how to do this from scratch. So these were the very first two equations which we have written. Moving on to the next two, which are a little difficult versions, but then it's very simple when we learn it properly. So again, I'll use alt is equal to, not going into the insert tab and all those. Over here, the outside is, the outermost is the lim or the limit, which is in this particular structure, limit and log. As you can see, there is only one limit. So I'll just click on this one. You can start from writing x tends to 5. So you can use your keyboard to type an x over here. It gives you the same exact x which you see. Then you need an arrow. Now, as I showed you all in the symbol section, we have arrows as well. So I'll click on the arrows, and over here we have different types of arrows. You need the second one, the very basic one, and it tends to 5. So that's your limit x tends to 5. Now I'll click on this box again. You need a fraction, so I'll insert this fraction. In this fraction, on the numerator, we have again an x square. So again, what you need is a superscript and subscript, and we are very lucky because we have this in our common superscript and subscript. So I can just click on this particular one and you get x square, and I'll type in minus 25. Again, the numerator, we are very lucky to have x square over here. So plus x minus 30. So this gives us the very third equation which we have written. Moving on to the fourth one, again a easy one. So I'll just click on alt is equal to, I hope I'm not going fast because these are really simple ones, because we are going just from scratch writing all the equations. This one is, yes, a little you can say difficult from the prior ones we have done, because this seems a little big equation, but then it's really simple again. So I'll type in s bracket. You can use normal brackets if you want to, and if you want to use these brackets, you can do that as well. So I'll take this bracket only, it's up to you. Is equal to, then we have the outermost is the integral which you see, a definite integral. So I'll select the definite integral from here. On the top we have k, we have over here as 1. So integral 1 to k, inside it we have 2 pi. So I'm just moving from left to right as we do if we are using a pen and paper. So I'll write 2 and then I'll write a pi, which we get again from the symbol section over here. All of these which we are doing, we are going to the symbol section and then using a pi. You have a shortcut for pi as well, which you are going to learn in our next class. Then we have 1/x again in the fraction section, 1, and you write an x over here. Then we have the entire square root. So I'll use this entire first square root. Again, you'll click on this box. Within this we have 1 plus. Then what do you do? Do you write the bracket first, the box bracket, or do you give the superscript which you have over here? So we have a superscript, so I think we should write the superscript, because if you start with the bracket, then it ends up a messy one, because then you need to use a shortcut basically to get the superscript. So it's easier if you start with the outermost, that is the superscript, right? Inside this, obviously we'll add the third bracket, so I'm going to add the third bracket. Again, we have something in fraction d/dx. We are lucky to have this in our common fraction, just that we don't have d/dx, we just have d/dx. So I can select this and let's see what we can do. I can remove this 5. So it's exactly similar. I don't have to type it down. I can just remove 5. Then that saves some of the time, maybe 1 or 2 seconds. Then we have 1 by x within the first brackets. So I insert the first bracket. In this, again, we have a fraction as 1 by x. I do not see any 1 by x. So it's easier if we type in the fraction 1 by x from scratch. Over here on top, we have 2. So that's it. Now the next thing we need to write is dx. So if we just type dx just like that, it gets typed in inside the square root. So what do we do? What do we need to do? We just click twice space. So 1, 2. Let me just check this. Twice you need to click on space, or maybe you can just, what do you have to do once you are inside this thing? You just need to click on the outside, anywhere outside this particular square root function which you have. Suppose if you are here, you can just need to click anywhere else and click, try to click on the very rightmost portion, and maybe you get it over here. Once we use shortcuts, I think this becomes easier. I'll just write dx and we get a dx. So this is the entire function which we get. Now we have successfully written 4 of our equations. What we can do is, suppose, which I'm going to deal with in our next class, suppose I had to write within this maybe something as k is equal to something, and if you write it within the equation, do not worry if you write it within the equation, because then you can change this and it can come out of the equation as well. So we'll deal with all these in our next class. Also, when we have written this equation, there are few things which we can do with this. What we can do is, when you click on this drop down over here, you can change the position, change to display, and also you can use, it comes to the very middle. When once you click on the justification over here, or let me do one thing, let me just scroll this down a bit. And once you click on this justification over here, you can change it as to the left aligned equation, right aligned equation, or simply keep it to be in the center, right? Also, what I can do is, I can add this to our built-in functions over here. What I can do is, I can just click on this and I can click on the save as new equation. The moment I click on save as new equation, you can save this entire equation and it creates a new building block within your existing built-in equations. So currently I'm not doing that. You can do that anyway. And then if you want to remove any built-in equation, what you do is, you just simply right click and then you can delete, organize and delete. You can just simply delete, click on this, and you can then simply delete any one of these equations which you see, right? So that can also be done. So this was it for my first class, where I have shown you all how to write the very basic 4 functions from scratch without using any shortcuts. Just one shortcut we have learned, which is alt is equal to. So I would suggest you all to go in and type these 4 shortcuts, these 4 equations only, and the first time you write it, it will not take more than 15 minutes for you all the first time, and maybe the second time it just takes you maybe 4 to 5 minutes to type these 4 equations. So that's it for my first class. Thank you. I hope you all enjoyed my first class in mathematical typing. Let me know how was my class. Thank you.